Thanks for the invite. It's an honor to be amongst you. So I'm sure that every one of you will be facing patients or relatives asking questions about knee replacement, whether I can avoid it as a real option. Next slide, please. And click the page. I'm sure that this is a wonderful procedure, especially look at the patient on the left side, the knee is totally eroded, unable to walk. And on the next image, you can see, click the phone. And knee replacement is done, the happy patient walking, the third day after the surgery. Okay? So it's a good surgery if done on the right patient, but next slide. But many times, this is how the knee looks. We have a prosthesis, make cuts in the tibia and femur, and apply, make the limb straight, and achieve this. Next, please. Sometimes we have a good knee replacement, golden knee replacement, good x-ray. There are no catastrophic side effects. Still the patients are unhappy. People say that I'm not feeling natural. There's some stiffness, some instability, some pain. So these are the unhappy patients we are talking about. Next. So these are the numbers. 1 out of 5 total knee replacement patients may be unhappy. And for every 3 patients who are now undergoing knee replacement surgery, at least 1 person we can prevent or postpone. So my talk is not about 3 patients, about 1 patient. Next slide, please. And the key to a successful knee replacement is doing it on the right patient. That is bone on bone. There should be absolutely no cartilage and bone touching the bone, eroding the bone. So this is a right indication. On the left, you can see 3 stages, 3 varieties of patients. 40-year-old person with severe knee pain, and 55-year-old female with severe knee pain, you can see the bones are just touching each other. And the third is a bone-on-bone articulation where the bone is eroding to each other. And these patients received different type of patients. We did just an alignment correction for this lady and a partial knee replacement and the total knee replacement. So this is how we select. A partial knee replacement is wonderful surgery, no ligaments cut, nothing, but we should be done on the right patient. And alignment chain surgery, much younger patients, just make the bone straight, redistribute the load to the normal compartment, it gives an excellent result. Next slide, please. So we are worried about patients who start having knee pain with the nearly normal x-ray on the left side, would go on to a stage where they require knee replacement. So how we are going to manage this treatment gap? The gap from where they start having symptoms, where they require knee replacement. Next slide, please. So in this treatment gap, we are having a lot of exacerbations, periods of exacerbation where they come with pain, but it's settled down. So we have to identify what are the reasons of severe pain in otherwise low-grade knee pain. It could be a meniscal tear, it could be a bone stress fracture which heals with the wrist, and it could be overload. They start walking, jogging, they develop knee pain. Just give them 2 months rest, they will not require knee replacement. And patellofemoral pain, it's a different entity which cannot be addressed by your knee replacement. Next slide, please. So once you understand what are the factors responsible for osteoarthritis, you should be able to modify them. Age, we know that, but obesity, for every kg you drop, you reduce the load on the knee by 3 kgs. Or if you lose 5 kg, the load on the knee reduces by nearly 15 kgs. So this effect of weight loss can help. Muscle strength. Once again, we see patients with poor x-ray, bad x-rays, but they don't have much symptoms. These people can walk for 1 hour also because they have good muscle strength. Same is true for football players. They damage their knee playing and their careers, but still x-ray looks bad. They're able to manage normally. The good muscle strength is also important. Alignment. People with bones have more tendency to develop that wear and tear, and young patients who are neglected with ligament tear, meniscal tear, they go on to develop very early arthritis as early as 40-45 years. Very important to address ligament and meniscal tear in patients. Next slide, please. So, it's very important when you treat these conditions, you should understand this healing layer. We need cells, stem cells or whatever, and we need growth factors. But it's very important, the environment in the knee joint should favor the healing. So, the environment is not good. Whatever magic remedies you add, inject, anything, it's not going to help. Next slide, please. So these are the strategies. You have to understand what is the cause of the trouble in this patient and try to address this. Of course, weight loss and whatever, there are so many magic remedies are being advertised now. It's very important to treat the aggravating patients in each patient, see whether the conservative treatment gives them this. In young patients, we can do cartilage repair, ligament, meniscus treatment, and in middle-aged patients, alignment corrections. Just unload the knee by straightening the tibia can help in preventing or postponing knee replacement. And in elderly patients, sometimes a partial knee replacement can be a well-tolerated procedure than a total knee replacement. Next slide, please. So coming to this quick magic remedies, now we have all these advertisements and all the forwards and WhatsApp, Facebook. People go to spend lakhs and lakhs in just getting your bone marrow taken and injected in the knee joint. If you are having a bow leg or you have a damaged knee, this is not going to work wonders. So another treatment is platelet-rich plasma. People say that you take blood and you I use them a lot in sports injuries. It's very good for soft tissue injuries, but not proven in knee problems. So just spending 60,000 or 70,000 rupees in giving this PRP with a region and hoping your knee become all right is useless. Once again, bone marrow stem cells. They take bone marrow, concentrated injected with knee joint. I use it for cartilage repair where there's a total cartilage repair. But for a generalized wear and tear patient, 60 years patient, whether it's going to work, there is no evidence. I think we should not waste money on this treatment. Similarly, hyaluronic acid injection, lot of value. And a lot of nerve operations are being carried out in pain clinics. Extreme old patients who are unfit, maybe that helps. But in patients, we should not do nerve operations because it can be the neuropathic joint. You lose the pain, the joint actually worsens. Next slide, please. So for example, there's a 36-year-old dancer who had a complete meniscectomy in USA, came with severe pain, she's unable to walk, offered knee replacement in 3 centers, did almost 5 years ago. You can see the joint space is narrowed. Next slide, please. She also had a cartilage repair damage, so we took the bone marrow and concentrated into the gel form. Next slide, please. Keep on the image here. So this is how the knee was looking. Where you can see, this is a medial femoral condyle, there is a big crack without cartilage here. Okay, so we clear the cartilage by dividing the loose cartilage. So this is a lesion without cartilage. And you can see there is a meniscus is already torn. She also had a small tear in the tibia. So what we did was we cleared this cartilage until all the unhealthy cartilages are removed. So we did microfracture pull, skip some more. And after taking the saline out, the bone marrow mesenchymal stem cell concentrate is injected and applied as a gel form to the cartilage. So this is a BMAC gel. And this cartilage repair has to be protected from overloading. So this is a stem cell cartilage repair. So this kind of focal lesions, we can use all the stem cells. But for 65 years old person, injecting blindly with an injury is not going to help you. Okay. So this is the cartilage defect being applied using a stem cell fibrin gel together. So this is nicely set in the form of plastic like consistency within 2 minutes. And then even if you move the knee, it will stay put nicely. Next slide, please. And once you've done this for the medial compartment, as you can see, we put a plate. We cut the tibia, slightly open it up, and shift the load to the lateral compartment. So there will be less load going to the medial compartment. This is an unloading surgery. The patient was able to keep the last image, please. And the patient is able to go back to walking and, okay, so 36-year-old person undergoing knee replacement, we should think something else. So this has been a successful case for us. Next, please. And this is another patient, 29-year-old patient, you can see the defect. Once you do the cartilage repair, next slide please. And because he's such a obese person, once again he had to do this knee unloading surgery. So this is very helpful osteotomy. Patient will have very good pain relief. Next slide please. So another example is a 30-year-old female, very obese, you can see. You can see this is a medial meniscus which is slipped out of the joint. You can see the small piece of the medial meniscus is totally out of the joint. So she practically had no protection for the medial compartment. Next slide, please. So we plan to repair the meniscus as well as to unload the joint. So the unloading surgery, we do all these calculations. It has to be done very precisely. So we know how much to open the tibia to unload the joint. So all these calculations are made in the software. Next slide, please. So this is how the knee looked, totally gone. She's just 39, almost grade 3 damage in the knee. The meniscus was totally pulled off. So on the last slide, you can see the meniscus has been repaired with sutures. Next slide, please. And once again, the knee is unloaded. So from the damaged compartment, the weight has been shifted to the normal compartment. So this is a principle of knee preservation. Next slide, please. And a lot of time, the kneecap, the patella can be a significant source of pain. Flip image. So this patient was brought to the OP with a wheelchair. She is unable to walk, severe pain. But the x-ray was relatively normal. So she had a lot of pain on the patella. So what I am doing is a taping. So just shift the patella so that the painful parts will not rub against each other. So this can be done in the clinic itself. So there is a lateral plate taping is applied. So this is a simple pressing material what we do for pressing postoperative wounds. So just shift the patella medially. And another tape to shift the patella still more medially. So this will give a diagnostic flow. So So these are severe painful patients, but simple taping and some exercises will help them walk within 1 or 2 weeks' time. So you can see the wheelchair in which she was brought. Now she is able to bear weight. Within 2 weeks of rehabilitation and VMS tempering and stretching, she was able to walk normally. So if you do knee replacement for this scenario, the patient is not going to improve. So your diagnosis should be correct. Next slide, please. It can be done in inpatients. Next slide, please. It can also be done in adult patients. But your diagnosis and your indications should be correct. Next slide, please. And in elderly patients, for example, this female, a 65-year-old female, comes with severe knee pain. We did arthroscopy, but meniscus could not be repaired. You can see the MRI here showing hyperintense signals. This is a stress fracture of the tibia, okay? Because bone is osteoporotic, she's walking too much, there is a stress fracture. So what we did is put her on armored belly and gave this unloading brace. Now it's 1 year, she's walking without knee replacement. So this is the principle. What is the cause of severe pain in the patient? This pain is a stress fracture. The stress fracture will heal. So only we need to have time and we need to try all these measures for this one. Okay, next slide please. So from evidence-based medicine, this is an area of value-based medicine. Okay, the value of a treatment is determined by the outcome, by cost. Okay, in evidence-based medicine, it's a cost effectiveness and what will work for the majority of the population. But here, we try to give the best possible relationship between optimal outcome of a treatment and the expenditure incurred to achieve the result. But if an individual patient perceives his or her health to be priceless, then cost becomes irrelevant. So that's the policy. If your knee is very important, spending few lakhs trying this treatment before you go for knee replacement, a lot of people are willing to accept, then going for a permanent procedure in which there is no hope of coming back. It's just you don't just anymore. Next slide, please. So, to summarize, if you want to try to preserve a joint, you have to understand the joint. Your diagnosis of each person should be very correct and specific. Your diagnosis directly correlates to the outcome. And also, it is a shared decision making. You cannot just say that I can preserve any joint. There are areas where you can fail. There are areas where you can give expected outcome. But both the patient and the doctor should be able to understand the limitations of each and every condition. And then it's a shared decision making. Once you know the plus minus of everything, and definitely they can result in a better outcome. So with this, once again, say that it's not anything against knee replacement. Knee replacement is a very good surgery, it's a precise surgery. But a certain amount of people can still postpone by another 5 to 10 years or maybe 15 years. So because if you preserve the knee, whatever knee you have from the birth, it is a high functioning knee that gives a normal knee feedback, normal joint position is. That when you have a knee replacement, you'll feel happy when you have suffered enough. But if you're not suffered enough, you're done in the early stage. The feeling may not be natural, you feel a bit wobbly. And basically everything works well, but still you're unhappy. We don't want to have unhappy patients. So that's my intention of talk, and thanks once again for listening. Any questions?
Knee replacement,
The plate will be almost 50,000 rupees. There are plates available for 5,000 also Indian ones. But we routinely use 50,000 rupees. And the fillers, what we use, 17,000 rupees. So it comes around 2 lakhs. It can be done for Indian patient within 60,000-70,000 total package also. The rest will be there. But standard care will be around 2 to 2.5 lakhs.
What is the role of
a
chondroitin secreted glucose remaining?
Sir, now it is not that much supported, sir. There are so many studies, some are sponsored by the industry, but in very early stages, I think the patients with exercises and they are improving, we can give. I give it because it gives a lot of something like a placebo effect also. But now the current trend is, it's not being emphasized. It may be in the joint preservation books. Recently, introduced by the European Society, this comes as a last pharmaceutical option. Even the curcumin and other things, Australia and all, they come before combating surgery. I will routinely recommend it, but you don't need the patient to have some confidence if he's still here. There's no harm in doing it.
Now, I request Dr. Dema to come for a hand of the therapy negotiation to Dr. Dean Clement Joseph. Please come.